Yesterday, the Palo Duro High School's culinary team headed to Austin for its regional competition.
That's right, and I caught up with the student chefs to learn their recipe for success.
Patience.
That's the main ingredient Chef Mario Hernandez says has helped him lead the Palo Duro High School's culinary team for the past 7 years.
A lot of patience just to adjust for students in different teaching styles.
And this year, with a team of 5 student chefs, Hernandez is hoping to snag a national title for the team. But first, they'll have to compete in regionals.
The students came up with their own recipes, and that's part of the competition where they come up with their own recipes. They actually write the recipes, they're judged on all their paperwork, so they have to price them out, make a menu.
And that menu is a full course meal made up of perfectly cooked beef tenderloins and a filet mignon.
We have a bunch of nitty gritty things like what the judges see, our knife cuts.
Senior chef Melissa Ramirez says no matter how cutthroat the competition may get, communication is always key.
Since we're a small team, we really have to talk to each other to make sure that we'll do good.
And after spending 3 years under the direction of Chef, Ramirez says thanks to him, she and other students graduate with an important set of skills.
Chef is a really good teacher. Chef always gets mad at us, for good reason too. In cooking, baking, anything you do in culinary, details are key. So if you put a little bit too much of something or a little too less of something, it completely ruins the recipe. So attention to detail is very important, and I think that would help me in college and everything else I would do, even if I wasn't in culinary.
A recipe for success that goes beyond the kitchen.
Now the team is expected to compete against 26 other high school teams.
And the top 6 teams will then move on to state. Oh, man.
So we wish them sweet success this
weekend.
Ah,
filet mignon, a beef tenderloin.
Do you smell that? Smells like success. David, you smell that?
You'd smell it all the way over there in the weather center, I'm sure. Ugh. I'd like some sides, though, too. I'm a big fan of sides. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I base, like, when I go to the restaurants, like, I try to base my choices on what sides. If I get, like, 1 or 2 sides, I don't know. It's one of those things. If I only get one side, I'm not gonna
do it. Sides are very important, for sure.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.